Today we're going to look at how we prepare growth media, which is used by microorganisms in order to meet their nutritional requirements and allow us to grow them in a laboratory setting. There are two types of growth media that we can use. One type is called chemically defined, where every single component that goes into that media is known, both the component as well as its concentration. So if I look at this recipe here of minimal media, we can see both the amounts as well as every single component that goes into making this media. The other type of media we have is complex media. And in complex media, we have an unknown component or concentration. An example of complex media is Luria Brittani or LB. If I look at the recipe for LB, we notice that in one of the ingredients, we have 5 grams of yeast extract. That yeast extract is not well defined, and depending upon what yeast you use and when that extract was made, that extract can differ between preparations. So for that reason, we define LB media to be complex. Our growth media can come in two forms. One type is where we prepare a liquid suspension or broth, or we can prepare the growth media in a semi-solid form using a solidifying agent known as agar. Agar is derived from algae. And it has the interesting property that it melts at 100 degrees Celsius, but solidifies at 42 degrees Celsius. So this allows us to grow microorganisms on a semi-solid form at relatively high temperatures, since the melting point is not going to be until 100 degrees. Semi-solid forms that we can use are tubes, slants, or plates. So if I want to make about 20 agar plates, I'll prepare about 500 mils of media containing agar. And if I want to make about 40 plates, I'll prepare 1,000 milliliters or 1 liter of agar with my growth media. So we prepare semi-solid forms of our media with agar, it's important to note that the agar is not digested by microorganisms. Therefore, the agar is added to either a chemically defined or a complex media in order to make that preparation. So now we're going to take a look at how we can prepare growth media. Most media come commercially available and in a dehydrated form, so simply just add water to your flask. You also need to consider what flask to use when preparing growth media. So if I wanted to prepare 200 mils of media, I'll use a flask that is 500 mils in total volume. If I want to prepare 500 mils of media, I'll prepare it in a 1 liter flask. And if I want to prepare 1 liter of media, I'll use 2 liter flask. We do this to make sure that there's no boil over occurring when we sterilize our media. So here I'm going to demonstrate how we prepare LB agar plates. So the first thing we need to do is to take our LB powder, and again it's in a dehydrated form, so we simply have to add water. If I read the directions say to add 25 grams of this powder to 1 liter of water. I only want to prepare 200 mils in this demo, so instead of adding 25 grams to 1 liter, I'm going to add 5 grams to 200 mils of water. So I'll begin by massing out 5 grams. We can then take our 200 mils of water and add. And now this is ready to be autoclaved or sterilized because we don't want any other microorganisms to grow in our media except the ones that we purposely inoculate onto this media. So to prepare it for autoclaving, we then take our cap, close it, but we don't want to seal it all the way. When we put this into an autoclave sterilizes liquid and other equipment that we use in the lab on temperature and pressure. So to make sure that this doesn't break, we're going to keep the cap loose. I'm going to take a piece of autoclave tape and rip off a small piece. And if you look at the autoclave tape, right now it's white. I'm going to attach it to the lid. After this is autoclaved, the tape is going to change color to show black lines. The black lines indicate that this bottle was autoclaved. I'll take some lab tape. I will write out what I've just prepared, so it'll be LB. I will put down my initials and today's date. And I will attach that also to my bottle. Ready to go into the autoclave. After it is autoclaved, the agar and the LB powder that I've added will dissolve, and then this will go sit in a water bath until I can easily handle it. If I want to add antibiotics to my media or any other indicators, those are always added after autoclaving because the antibiotic will break down if it is put in before autoclaving. So here we have our media with the agar that came out of the autoclave and is cooled off in a water bath. If you look at the tape, you'll now see that the tape has black lines on it. So this shows you that this has been in an autoclave because the increased temperature and pressure from the autoclave results in that tape changing from white to black. So now we want to if we need to add any antibiotics or any special indicators like XGAL, if you're doing any blue-white screen cloning selecting, this would be the time that you add it to your media. We now want to transfer this into our plates, and the way we're going to begin that is by setting up an area, a sterile area, and for that we're going to use the Bunsen burner, so I'll turn on the gas. Light. And then to make sure that this media stays sterile, I'm going to work as close to the flame as possible. I'm going to uncap this, and then I'm going to flame the lip to make sure that the lip is sterile. And then taking my sterile petri dishes in this stack here, I'm going to lift up the pile just all of them except for the bottom plate, and I'm holding the lid to that bottom plate. I then pour in some media just till it covers the bottom, and then I replace the pile. I then grab the lid of the second to bottom plate, lift up, and then pour and replace the pile. Every now and again, I'm going to flame the lip again and then continue pouring. When you're done, flame the lip, flame the cap, and then allow these to cool and solidify. After they have solidified, you can then store them either at room temperature if you're going to use them right away, or at 4 degrees if you're going to use them at a later date.